In this video, we discuss the physical reasons why resistance increases with temperature in an ordinary conductor. We state a simple linear formula for computing the increase in resistance with temperature, and we work an example to demonstrate how to use the formula. So what we're looking at in the first picture here is a simple model for what's going on in a conductor when there's a current flowing through it. Now in this conductor, current is actually flowing to the right, but we know what's really going on is that electrons are moving to the left at an average speed that's called the electron drift velocity. And I'll post a link to where I derived the electron drift velocity real quick. Now resistance arises in the conductor because of collisions with the atoms in a material. So like if this was a copper wire, these big red things here, those are the copper atoms. So when electrons collide with the atoms in a material, energy is dissipated and randomized and it turns into heat. And it translates into an increase in the temperature of the material. So these electrons are losing potential energy, but they always maintain the same speed. Why aren't they speeding up? That missing energy goes into the thermal energy that's heating up the material as the current flows. So how does higher temperature change the resistance of a material? That's what I'm trying to illustrate in the second picture. Temperature is literally the average kinetic energy of the particles in a material. And so what's happening as this thing gets hotter is the atoms in the material are vibrating faster and faster, and with larger and larger amplitude. Well, this means they effectively have a larger cross section as they're bouncing back and forth. You're more likely to have a collision with an electron. The classic metaphor here is that it's like trying to run past somebody who keeps jumping side to side. You're more likely to run into them than if they were standing still. So this is the physical reason why we expect resistance to increase with temperature. Now we get into our simple linear model for how to compute resistance changes as the temperature changes. And the first thing I'll do is phrase this in terms of the resistivity of the material. So there's a couple assumptions that go into this model. We have to assume that delta T is not exceptionally large. So this is a very simple linear model that's only going to work over a fairly narrow range of temperature changes. Also, I need to be clear about what rho naught is. So that's the resistivity of the material at some reference temperature that you're going to look up in a chart or that would be given to you in a problem. Finally, I wanted to just look at this new thing, alpha. That's called the temperature coefficient of resistivity. And that just measures how sensitive a material is to temperature changes. Like a material with a large alpha would have large resistivity changes when the temperature changes. And I want to look at the units of alpha real quick. In this term, alpha delta T, I've got to get just a constant out of that with no units on it. So when I add a 1 to that, basically that's going to give me a percentage change on the original resistivity. So for this to come out unitless, I need the units of alpha to be 1 over Celsius degrees. Now, we originally introduced resistivity in a video about how resistance depends on the length and cross-sectional area of a resistor. And I'll just go ahead and post a link to that real quick. And in that video, we deduced this formula that resistance is equal to the resistivity times the length over area. The main point being right now that the resistance of a resistor is proportional to the resistivity of the material. Well, if resistance is proportional to the resistivity of the material, then I could write my simple linear model like this. And that might be more useful depending on how a problem is given to you. All right, let's wrap things up with a simple example of how to apply this formula. So we're told that a nichrome resistor has a resistance of 5 ohms at a temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. And we know the temperature coefficient of resistivity for nichrome is about 0.0004 per degree Celsius. Now the chart that I used to find this, if I could be a little more specific, said that alpha is equal to 0.0004 per degree Celsius at 20 degrees Celsius. So it's important you pay attention to what the reference temperature is when you do these calculations. Then we're asked to find the resistance after the resistor heats up to 100 degrees Celsius. So this is a plus 80 for delta T. And in this case, I'm using the second formula. I don't have to go back and worry about resistivity and the length and cross-sectional area of the resistor. I know the original resistance is 5 ohms. I'll find my new resistance at the temperature T by taking the original resistance, 5 ohms, and multiplying by 1 plus alpha times delta T. And again, that alpha times delta T is unitless. So I end up with my original units of ohms, and I'm just scaling up the resistance here. When I run the numbers on this, I get 5.16 ohms for the final resistance. So that gives you a sense for what the magnitude of these changes with temperature really is. If you find the physics content on Zach's lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.